Good day, students. How are you all? I'm glad to have you with me today. Hope you are good. Today, we are going to be considering a topic titled Nigerian Crafts. And what are the lesson objectives? One, to understand the concepts craft. Two, to recognize various Nigerian crafts, their raw materials, and the cities of production. And thirdly, to outline the uses of various crafts. You should be able to let the people around you know, or me, the uses of various crafts available to us. Now, what is craft? Craft involves the practices that require the use of bare hands and creativities to produce something. Your bare hand. That is, apart from what machines, the robots can do, what can you do with your hand? What can you think about and bring out with your hand? Like furniture, carpentry, blacksmithing, etc. Your paper mache work, things you can think about and do it without the help of any machine, either simple or mechanized one. Now, there are some raw materials that are used in craft making, and their productions, and their places of productions. Now, here they are, calabash decoration. Calabash decoration is made from a material called gourd, and it's made in Kano. Pottery, your clay works, your pots, your flower vases, etc., made from clay, and it is common in Abuja. And thirdly, now, Bida, not really Abuja exactly, but in Niger State, but the city of Bida is known for pottery. That's why we have our Ladi Kwali. You remember that Ladi Kwali, that contemporary Nigerian artist who is a potter. Now, tie and dye. The material is dye stuff, and it is found in Seyin in Oyo State in Nigeria, in Oyo State in the Yoruba region of Nigeria. Now, mat weaving, the raw material is raffia, and it is common in the Ekiti State of Nigeria. Now, cloth weaving. The raw material is cotton, and it is found in Oyo State as well, or your town specifically. Now, bead making. Beads are the raw materials, and we have it also in Bida. Now, wood. I have beads here. I'm so sorry about that. We're going to correct that. It's supposed to be Bida, not beads. Sorry, that's a typographical error. Now, wood carving is common in Enugu State, in the eastern part of this country. Now, leather work too is much more common in Kano, as much as we have in Calabash. The Hausas are so much into calabash making. Now, into leather works. Now, here they are. Calabash decoration. Now, the uses includes, it serves us to save our food, I hope. In those days, during the prehistoric era or before history came up. Now, calabash was, and some of our pottery was a basic plate used in serving our foods, then to serve our drinks too, such as cups, then to serve in those days, especially in the Yoruba part of this country, palm wine was very prominent then. And instead of these are cups that we use, all these your glass cups and mugs, then it was calabash to drink, to take the palm wine. Now, to serve, it stored items such as jewelries, monies, etc. You can put your jewelries in it as a jewelry casket, then put the lid and keep it somewhere. It stays there, it preserves it as well. Now, let's go to tie and dye as one of the crafts. Now, the uses of tie and dye. Look at this beautiful young woman. See, look at what she's wearing. Look at how it fits. Now, the body is not exposed, and it enhances beauty on her. Look at it. Now, for covering of nakedness. A lot of us these days, now, the modernization in the world had made a lot of us, both men and women, to expose the very good part of their body. Look at this young woman with this fine tie and dye covering her body. Now, for covering of her nakedness, so that you won't see your nakedness outside, that's the basic important of cloth tie and dye. Then production of bags, shoes, and other special wares. Bags, shoes, that we do nowadays in creativity. Now, pottery. Now, the uses of pottery includes for food storage, for water storage, for cooking, and for keeping our jewelries, our pottery. You know what I'm talking about? In those days, before refrigerator came, now, our fathers and mothers were using big pots to keep our water cool. When you drink from that pot, you are going to appreciate it. You cannot from your grandma, I'm telling you. And for cooking, I was told by my grandma, let me give you the experience, that my grandmom, that the soup that is made from the natural pottery is sweeter than the one that is made from these are modern pots we have now, they're made of aluminium. That there's even some nutrients in it that helps your health. Also, for keeping our jewelries, okay? Leather work. Now, leather work, the uses of leather work includes production of various wares and items, such as our bags, your shoes, my belts, and clothing. In those days, even these days, the hunters do wear leathers. Even where information had not reached in our world today, you see them covering their nakedness with a leather, like the prehistoric artists did. You can see the picture of leather. You can see this beautiful sandal. See your birds. See this beautiful bag made from leather. It is very, very wonderful. Now, mat weaving. I told you it's prominent in Ekiti State of Nigeria, but all over the country. Now, the use of mat weaving includes sleeping at home. You sleep on instead of the mattress. In those days, before mattresses came, people were on mats, make mat, and enjoy themselves. Now, sleeping at home, outings and picnics. You go to the beach and all that, lay your mat on the floor, rest and play and all that. Then, for religious purpose, that one is very fundamental. The Muslim, when they get to Eidi, they lay mats, even in the mosque, see mat on the floor, people lie down there. The Christians too, when they go to picnics, program, even in their churches, worship centers, they put mat on the floor and pray through it. And that comes to the end of the video. Now, students, in your Google classroom, I want you to try as much as possible, go through this and go through the what we have put there. Then do your class tasks. And if there's any question or if you are confused and you need further understanding, meet me in the Google classroom. And let's have a good day. Thank you very much.